sky, 'cause you're a sky full of stars. I'm gonna give you my heart, 'cause you're a sky, 'cause you're a sky full of stars. 'Cause you light up the path.
Does anybody know what the new translation of Hine Matovu Manayim Shevetachim Gam Yachad means? Nothing about how good are your tents on Jacob. Anybody know? Hine Matovu Manayim Shevetachim Gam Yachad literally translates now, please put your cell phones on silent. This is truly a joyous celebration for Andrew, for Stephen, for Fatima, for the family, for friends. And what I'd like to do is we'd like to begin, and we would like to ask Mom and Dad to come up, because they're going to present Andrew with his talk.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidishanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu lahatner lahitatei batzit. Blessed O Lord our God, ruler of the universe, who hallows us with his mitzvot,
and teaches us to wrap ourselves in the fringes of
the sun. Now, as a, Mom, you're missing an opportunity to give a kiss. As I told Andrew, there's going to be a lot of kissing going on tonight, so he's ready for it. Thank you. Andrew's going to be leading the service this evening, and it's truly a joy to have everybody here to celebrate tonight. And he knows his material, and we're going to have a wonderful celebration tonight. I continue on page 3 in the book with the reader's cottage. Da shemerabo bialma de brother te bialif malfutai mechayechon of yomechon of chayir hapek Yisrael bagala bagala of his man korif imru amen yehesh meirabo mavara le'olam olmeh mayo On page 4, we ask you to please rise. We read together at the bottom of page 4, the last paragraph. Let all bless you, O Lord our God, for your excellence of your handiwork and for your glowing stars that you have made. We read together. Then shall we never be shamed. We shall put our trust in you, the great Holy and Lofty One. We shall rejoice and be glad in your salvation. For you, O God, are the author of many wonders. In love you have chosen us and drawn us near to you, to serve you in faithfulness and to proclaim your name. Blessed is the Lord, who in love has chosen his people Israel to serve him. Baruch atah Adonai. We read together the watchword of our faith. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord is one. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai. Tam al-Mazazor Beitecha, Uvisharecha, Lama'an Tizkaru Va'asitem, et kol mitzvotai, v'yitem kedoshim l'elokechem, ani Adonai Elokechem, asher hotzei etchem, me'eretz Mitzrayim, l'hiyot lachem l'elohim, ani Adonai Elokechem.
We read responsibly. True and enduring, beloved and precious, awesome, good, and beautiful is this eternal teacher.
This truth we hold to be forever certain. The eternal God is our King. He is the rock of Jacob, our protecting shield.
He abides through all generations. His name is eternal. His throne stands forever. His serenity and faithfulness are everlasting.
Together. His words live and endure, true and precious to all eternity.
Lord our God, you redeemed us from Egypt.
You set us free from the house of bondage.
For this, the people who felt your love sang songs of praise to you.
The living God, high and exalted, mighty and awesome.
Who humbles the proud and raises the lowly, who frees the captive and redeems the oppressed.
Who is the answer to all who cry out to him.
All praise to God Most High, the source of blessing. With Moses and Israel, we sing to him the song of rejoicing.
Mi kamocha oeli madonai, mi kamocha nedar bakodesh, nora tehilot hasafala, nora tehilot hasafala. Mahud korovanacha zeli anearu. Shira chadasha shimchu geolim L'shimcha shvach hayom Yachad kulam odu ve'imlichu amaru Adonai imloch le'olam vod Tzu Yisroel, Tzu Yisroel Ma'bezrat Yisroel Uma Bezrat Yisroel. Go aleinu, Adonai Tzevaot Shemo, Kadosh Yisroel. Baruch Atah Adonai, Go al Yisroel. Eternal God, open my lips, that my mouth may declare your glory. Read together. Eternal is your might, O Lord. All life is your gift. Great is your power to save. With love you sustain the living. You bring freedom to the captive. Keep faith in those who sleep in the dark. Who is like you, Master? Nekadesh et shimcha b'olom Hishem shemakdish imotko b'shemei maharom Hakatuv al yod nevi'echa mekorozaza Melo, kol haaretz, kevod
L'dor v'dor, hallelujah. L'dor v'dor nagigat lecha. To all generations, we will make it known your greatness, and to all eternity, proclaim your holiness. Your praise, O God, shall never depart from our lips. Blessed is the Lord, the Holy God. Baruch atah Adonai ha'el ha'kadosh. Crown of salvation, a day of rest and holiness. Abraham rejoiced in it, and Isaac sang, and Jacob and his children were refreshed by its rest. In this rest are love and sharing, truth and faithfulness, and peace, quiet and safety. It is a perfect rest that you have willed. And may your children come to understand that this Sabbath rest links them to you, that by that they will hallow your name. We read together, bottom of 12. Our God and God of all ages past, may our rest on this day be pleasing to your sight. Sanctify us with your Mitzvah, and let your Torah be a way of life. Satisfy us with your goodness, and gladden us with salvation, and purify our hearts to serve you in truth. In your gracious love, O Lord our God, let your holy Sabbath remain our heritage, that all Israel, hallowing your name, may find rest and peace. Blessed is the Lord for the Sabbath. Ritzei Adonai Eloheinu b'yamchai Yisrael u'tfilatam b'havat kamel v'tehil l'ratzot tamid avodat Yisrael l'mecha al karov l'chol kariv v'nei el avdecha v'chaneinu shefuk ruchacha eleinu v'techezena ineinu v'shuatecha l'tzion v'rachami baruch ataranai ha'machazir shechinato l'tzion bottom page 14 modim anachdu lach sh'atahu Adonai Eloheinu b'lehi avotenu le'elam v'ed. We gratefully acknowledge that you are the Lord our God and God of our people, God of all generations. You are the rock of our life, the power that shields us in every age. We thank you and we sing your praises for our lives which are in your hand and for our souls which are in your keeping, for the signs of your presence that we encounter every day, and for your wondrous gifts at all times. Morning, noon, and night, you are goodness, your mercies never end. You are compassion. Your love will never fail. You have always been our hope. And for all these things, O sovereign God, let your name be forever exalted and let it be blessed. O God, Redeemer and Helper, let all who live affirm you and praise your name in truth. Lord, whose name is goodness, we give you thanks, we give you praise. There comes a time in every service where we have an opportunity to reflect. Say a little prayer in your heart. The love that we have for family is very special, but we hope and pray that everyone will have joy and happiness in their lives so that family will be able to celebrate and that there is good health in everybody's lives. So please take a moment. Shalom Rav al Yisrael Amcha, Kasin Leolam. Shalom Rav al Yisrael Amcha, Kasin Leolam. Ki atahu melech Adon lechol ha-shalom. Ki atahu melech Adon lechol ha-shalom. Shalom Rav al Yisrael Amcha, Kasin Leolam. Shalom Rav al Yisrael Amcha, Kasin Leolam. We continue on page 16 with the beginning of the Torah service, which is the real reason why we are here tonight. Ein kemocha Elohim Adonai, uvein kemasecha. Malchutecha malchut kol olamim, umemshalecha bechol dor vador. Adonai malach, Adonai malach, Adonaim loch leolam v'olet. Adonai os leamo yitein, Adonai yivoreh. Please rise. Avarachamim heitivav reitzonecho et zion Yibnei chamatir shalayim Yivav levavetav melech kol koram benitzadon olamim Avodot Eloheinu tenu kavod Torah. Let us declare the greatness of our God and give honor to the Torah. Ki Mitzion Tetze Torah. Ki Mitzion Tetze Torah. Levar Adonai Merushalayim. Baruch Sheratan Torah Torah. Baruch Sheratan Torah Torah. Le'amol Yisrael. In a few moments, Andrew is going to take the Torah. He's going to have it against his shoulder. And he is going to walk down the center aisle to the back of the room. He's going to head to the side where there are other people sitting. And as he goes down the room and then comes back, those of you who wish who are by the aisles, feel free to take your books, touch the Torah, or kiss your hand and touch the Torah, and there's going to be some wonderful explanations about this sacred Torah in just a few moments when Andrew has completed his actual Torah reading. We continue the middle of the page with the Shema. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord is one. Echad Eloheinu, Gadol Adonainu, Kadosh Shemo. Our God is one, our Lord is great. Holy is his name. God Lula the Naiti and Roma Mashamo Yachtav. Oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name. We can basically do whatever we want to do as far as having family come up for the blessing. So we're going to be a little bit unorthodox tonight. And we're going to start and we're going to ask a couple of people to come up and do the aliyahs. We'd like to ask first, and I'll give the list of names and then everybody can start to come up, and you can come up on both sides. We're going to ask for Bella and Manny and Samantha, for Jack and Jackie, and Madison, and Miranda, and Mackenzie, for Michelle, and for Jacob and Lucas, for Manuel to come up, for Tasha and Kayla to come up, for Minda and Orlando, and Anna and Ricky, and Roy and Yelena, and Mickey and Lexi, and OJ. Thank you. I love it. What we're going to do is we're going to have this wonderful part of the family come up, and they're up here and they're going to do the blessing. Okay? Amen. And if you can do the second blessing, which is on the bottom half of the page. Now, I'm going to move to the side because everybody who's up here wants to give them what's good. All right, kissing time again. Come on, man. Baruch et Adonai HaMorah, Baruch Adonai HaMorah Le'olam Ba'ed, Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Asher Baharanu Mikol HaMin, Menata Lamanu Et Torato, Baruch Ata Adonai Elohein HaTorah. Amen. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech haolam, Asher natan lanu Torah tamed, v'chayim atah Eloheinu, Baruch atah Adonai notein haTorah. All right, Mom, Dad, bring your notes. Now, it gives me a lot of joy to be able to physically call our Bar Mitzvah boy for the volunteer. Yamon, Yamon, Aminatan, Habachor, Habar Mitzvah. Baruch Adonai HaMorah Le'olam Ba'ed.
Amen. Because he is the firstborn, Esau is to get double But in addition to this advantage, in the Hebrew tradition, the firstborn also has a special responsibility of continuing the family's religious inheritance. The firstborn must be an example to the other ones. He is a religious and spiritual vessel. Esau is not qualified to carry out this religious responsibility. The Sidra reveals a clear example of Esau's wild and irresponsible way. He rushes home one day, tired from the hunt. It smells the delicious aroma of chicken and supplemental soup. Give me some of the red stuff in your pot, he says to Jacob. I feel faith. Sell me your birthright, proposes Jacob, knowing how impulsive his brother is in testing his conduct. I am dying of hunger, returns Esau, and what good will the birthright be to me when I am dead? Jacob sees that Esau is not very concerned and insists, swear to me first. You want the birthright for lentils? It's yours. Esau thinks no more about the birthright than a dish of lentils. Explore and eat and forgot all about them. Years pass after the lentil soup is eaten. Isaac, the father, grows old and black. He feels that death may be coming and he is concerned about his family's future. He decides to make known his last will and testament. In keeping the birthright tradition, he automatically assumes that Esau will be the spiritual heir. Isaac has not known that Esau's birthright is soup swap with his name. He summons Esau to bear a pair of meals with Isaac, at which Isaac will hit Esau with his own blessing. Esau, having forgotten the deal he made with Jacob, in a hasty moment rushes enthusiastically to prepare for the blessing of the birthright by his father's side. Rebecca has overheard Isaac invite Esau, and she is satisfied. She knows that Esau is not qualified to carry out the leadership responsibility which are becoming the people. And she remembers the prophecy that the elder shall serve the younger. Now that the birthright is being handed on to the next generation, Rebecca decides to action for Isaac, knowing that Isaac loves and prefers his older son. The blessing must go to Jacob. So Rebecca feels more worthy to carry on the spiritual tradition of his father. Rebecca urges Jacob to come to the homeless black of Isaac and to take the birthright blessing. Jacob urges against Rebecca's plan. He is not eager to deceive his father, but Rebecca insists that she will take the blame for his father. Reluctantly, Jacob agrees. He comes fearfully to his father and Isaac for the blessing. Isaac hesitates for a moment because somehow the voice that hears and he hears is not a blessing. But Isaac's temporary doubt passes, and he gives the birthright blessing to Jacob. When Esau returns with food for the blessing of his father, the whole matter comes out into the open. Isaac reveals to Esau what has happened, and his son cries bitterly with disappointment. Bless me also, my father, who is soon after. Isaac cannot now withdraw the birthright blessing which he has already given to Jacob through deception of his younger son. He blesses Esau, saying, you shall serve your brother, but the time will come when you shall shave your beard of a goat of his race. But Esau is not satisfied and is eager for revenge. On the advice of Rebecca, Jacob leaves home to seek refuge from Esau's anger in a far-off country of Mesopotamia, in which Abraham and Rebecca had originally come. Jacob was soon to have paid the penalty for treating his brother as his name.
The next part of the service, Andrew will do the Haftorah portion.
Mashal Jabbar Adonai El Yisrael, we got an old thing. Ahati Yehem, Amar Adonai, Ba'amartem, Ma Abatu, Ho'ach, Isa, Fiako, Ne'um Adonai, Ba'alhat, Ve'et Isa, Saniti, Ba'asim, Et Harab, Shimama, Ve'et Nacholato, Natano, Medibar, Yitomar, Kitomar, Etom, Rusheshlu, Venashu, Venipe, Harambo, Koamar, Adonai, Siskao, Venipasu, Ve'ani, Eheros, Ve'karu, Lehem, Gibu, Rishan, Vahaem, Vasher, Zaham, Adonai, Adoram.
The Haftorah last of the prophets. All of these speaks his message around 450 BCE. Although the second temple has been rebuilt by now, Malachi is unhappy about the weakness of the people and their religious faith and responsibility. In the Haftarah, Malachi especially criticizes the priests who are in charge of the temple. They have not been good religious leaders among the people. They are not serious about the responsibility. Sacrifices animals is not all that God asks them to do. They must uphold truth in their business. This is the real purpose for which Jacob and his descendants have been chosen by God for Esau and those who have been after them. The priests must remember this, and they must lead the people back to God and take perpetual life. Have we all not one Father? Has not one God created us? Why do we deal treacherously every man against his brother?
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech HaOlam, Tzur Kol HaOlamim, Tzadik B'Kol HaDorot, HaEl HaNe'eman, HaOmer Ve'Oseh, HaMedaber U'Mekayem, SheKol Devarav, Emet Vatzedek. Andrew, you've completed the Torah reading, you've completed the Haftorah, and I can tell you that you're almost done. They know that your mom is really... The celebration tonight is truly very special. Andrew has a speech which he wants to give, and I am going to stop him at one point because I want to discuss a little bit about the sacred Torah, the Torah scroll that he read from.
I want to thank you all so much for coming to my bar mitzvah. To all my family that are here, you all have been so supportive through the years, especially this past year. I hope each and every one of you have met our family. To my Boko Nefesh, you have taught me so much. I remember you and I remember playing soccer in the backyard. We would play for hours throughout the day. This is some of the great memories I have. Boko, you are so special and close. To my friends, I'm happy that you all are here to celebrate this day with me. You make each and every day special now, whether we are at school, town, or just hanging around the house. Rabbi Dex, the first day I met you, I thought to myself, how am I going to learn all of this from my bar mitzvah? It just seemed crazy to me, but thanks to you, your patience and knowledge, I learned everything needed, and I can see that I have come all day with it. To my mom and dad, you have done everything for my special day. I will see you guys during the weekend and weekdays, planning the party, working on flat shows, designing the t-shirts, creating the guest list, food menus, etc. Too much for me to remember. None of this would have happened without you guys. Thank you so much. I love you. My sister, Tasha and Caitlin, for always being there, supporting, loving, my second office. Always fun times with these two. Love you both. When I was younger, my grandmother and grandfather, when they were 87, they would take me to church on Sundays. Even though I could not understand a single word that they were saying since it was in Portuguese, I started to think and learn about religion and faith. As I got older, I started to attend bar and bat mitzvah, a couple of communion, and some religious services. All of those experiences have taught me about faith.
Guys.
Over the years and throughout my time at UCC, we celebrated Hanukkah, Passover, and many Jewish holidays. I remember making a book about Passover, with drawings and different writings. My father would say the prayers during the holidays, and he taught me about Moses and the importance of having faith. All throughout my life, my dad would talk to me about my grandmother Nancy. About how my grandmother Nancy would take in homeless and sick animals. He told me how she even tried to help a sick bird back to health. It did not matter if it was a dog or if it was a cat. He told me she loved animals more than people, as he does. Over the years, I've had strong feelings about wanting to help animals, both with my time and someday hopefully with my life. For my mitzvah, I decided to go to Mount Pleasant Animal Shelter, where we adopted Mason, my best bud, and helped me out in any way. I worked in the back taking care of different chores and needed at the shelter. This has been a great experience. I plan on continuing to help one day. I can give my dad the greatest gifts of all time in becoming a veterinary teacher. Through my years, I've heard stories and seen movies about the Jewish plague. I have discussed it with my family, friends, and Rabbi Dennis. So I believe I should take a moment to reflect on this very important issue.
Every time I do a bar mitzvah, whether it's in my shul or whether it's outside of shul, I always specifically use this sefer Torah. This sefer Torah is very special to me. It's a Torah that's been at my temple, which is in the Bronx. I've been there for 42 years, and this Torah has been there since before I got there. This is a Holocaust survivor Torah. This Torah came from a synagogue just outside of Warsaw, Poland. Adolf Hitler took this Torah and thousands of other Torahs and Jewish artifacts. He wanted to put it into a museum that he was going to create for an extinct religion. Well, this sefer Torah is being used as often as I can. It's a joy to have this Torah here. It's a joy to have this Holocaust survivor with us tonight. And it's a joy for Andrew to have been able to walk through this congregation with this Torah, have you touch it, and be a part of this remembrance. But the joy that we have of celebrating with Andrew is truly the joy of what this bar mitzvah is all about. Making sure also that the Holocaust never happened.
From 1941 to 1945, the biggest genocide in history occurred. The Holocaust was a mass extermination of Jews. This was led by Nazi Germany during World War II. 6 million Jews were killed. There have been many stories about the Holocaust. Probably the biggest and most well-known is the diary of Anne Frank. Anne Frank was a German girl who was also Jewish. She kept a diary while she was hiding from the Nazis. Eventually, she was captured and taken to a concentration camp, where a few months later, Anne and her sister died. Even though Anne Frank died, to this day, Anne is still a big inspiration to me and many others that pray for peace, understanding, and most of all, tolerance in this world. So let me wish you all a happy and healthy new year. Thank you for being here, and most of all, enjoy the party.
They gave Andrew this beautiful finished cup, which is a part of the service tonight. And Helena, you can also come up. And Mark. We'd like to have Stephen and Andrew's grandfather, Manuel, come up, and Michael and Jack come up, because at every party, there's a challah. The challah has to be done, the challah has to be cut, and we have wonderful family members here who are going to do the blessing, and then we're going to have the opportunity to...
Fatima was going to get this piece.
So while we're going to step out of, we're going to step off script a little bit, like our president-elect, we're just even though we're so long. Milana, though, won't do that down to know what time is going to be when I can write. So when we had a lot of people that drove here, a lot of people that flew here, we want to thank you very much for coming and sharing this story a second. There is nobody that is in this place tonight. Nobody. From a business acquaintance or from an obligation that is here. Everybody that is in this room was wanted in this room for one special reason. To join in this night and to continue to share in Andrew's lives and in our lives. We want to thank you and we appreciate you coming. So this family has gone through a tremendous amount of ups and downs. And Andrew, being 13 years old today, has had a tremendous amount of family that has supported him. And most people in this room, in one way or another, has touched Andrew's lives since my parents and Fatima's mother has died more recently. The family has stayed together terrific. All the siblings have really stepped up, and as a group, I think we've joined together and really made for our nieces and nephews and Andrew's life a far better road than it would have been as some families split off. There are some people in this room that I need to call out, because I do. What we'll call aunts and uncles that are a little different than our normal aunts. So I think that Aunt Lorraine and Aunt Jan and Aunt Joan have been around my son forever. And when my mother passed away and Fatima's mother passed away, have played an active role in sharing their love and their thoughts and making sure that Andrew understood that everything Daddy said is a lie. We did that. From an uncle standpoint, I think that Uncle Sal and Uncle Patrick and Uncle Jamie and Michael, and to the point that Andrew walked out of a haircut a few weeks ago with Uncle Jamie and Michael and said to me, "Dad, you know, I want to move to California, but when I got to get my haircut, I'm going to have to fly back in order to get my haircut." I've really played that kind of role. It's been very special and very appreciated. I want everybody to know. The road to this night has certainly been an interesting one, as most of you all know, and most of you know as well. We are not the most religious people. But from an early time, there was a thought that we needed to bar mitzvah Andrew. And he had this feeling of faith, but I think never really understood what that faith was all about. So I'm going to tell a little story about faith in Andrew. So Andrew and I like to spend movie time together, usually Disney movies, because I like Disney movies. But there wasn't any Disney movies playing in town, and there was a movie named Miracles from Heaven playing in town, and I wasn't that familiar with the movie, and neither was Andrew. And Andrew said to me, "Let me go down on the computer and let me check out the trailer." And Andrew went down and checked out the trailer. And as the trailer was finishing for this movie, Andrew turned to me and said, "Dad, we're going to cry a lot in this movie. We're going to cry a lot in this movie." So we went to the movie, and three quarters of the way into the movie, all the napkins and tissues gone, and I cried a lot in this movie, and so did Andrew. Andrew turns to me and said, "Dad, is it okay if I have faith?" And I wanted to say to Andrew, "Be quiet, please, I'm watching the movie," but of course, Daddy couldn't say that. And he said, "You know, I'm not sure what that faith is, but is it okay if I have faith?" And for people that aren't familiar with this movie is about, a true story, about a mommy who has faith in her God and a daughter who has faith in life. And I really believe that with Andrew, that Andrew has this faith in life. And as we see here tonight, you know, we're not the most orthodox, and I think that's kind of nice, right? So here we are in upstairs in West Orange, New Jersey, with a great rabbi that I want to thank. I wish my son learned math as well as he learned Hebrew, so you know. You know, it's a difficult household we have. Fats and I. You know, we're very quiet people, me and Fats. We don't raise our voices very much. So you can imagine what the dinner conversations are in our house, right? You have a father that goes to father-son weekend at Greylock, and most fathers run to the basketball court, and most fathers run to go play baseball, and of course this is a father that said, let me take out the tweezers, I need to fix your eyebrows. So this is a father that says, you gotta wash your hands 20 times a day, right? Or you have a mommy that puts him in such tight, skinny jeans that he can't breathe. Or a mommy that took after my mommy at 6:30 in the morning tells his son he's got to make his bed, right? So, I'm getting a little old, so I need to make sure that I didn't forget someone. Did I talk about Uncle Patrick?
Yes.
I did. I mentioned Uncle Patrick as the uncles, or I did not?
Yes.
Please. Okay. Oh, very good. So, I think for Andrew, he has become this good young man. And I wasn't going to send Andrew to summer camp. And there's a lot of Greylock people in the back, and I'm sorry you're standing.
Shout out.
But Greylock learns how to teach boys how to become good young men. And Andrew has learned how to become a good young man. And through all the hardships, and listen, he's got a daddy that's not such an easy daddy on a variety of levels, and a mommy that's definitely not such an easy mom. Andrew's got a lot of love inside of him, a lot of good inside of him. You're gonna hit a lot of rocky roads in life. But you remember that life teaches us good and bad, but you have it in you to be good. We love you. We will always be with you. I have two daughters here I want to know. They turned out to be Jews, they're Portuguese, but so you know, they're Jews. They grew up in Short Hills, they wanted this to be their bat mitzvah as well. I did not give that to them, but tonight it's their night as well. So we love you, enjoy the night, happy New Year.
Tonight, this is a celebration. This is a celebration for Andrew. It's a celebration for family. The kids from Greylock, we're glad that you're here. We're glad that the aunts, the uncles, the cousins, the sisters, the brothers, the dad, and everybody is here with us. Family is what everything is all about. And having a celebration like this isn't just a bar mitzvah, this is a celebration. We are celebrating with Andrew tonight. And this is what life is about. We're not doing this in a synagogue, and we were able to have all of the family come up here to be a part of the celebration. And this is something that they will not forget. Now, on a different note, Mom and Dad, I'd like you to just hold hands for a moment. There is a small candle that is flickering on the table here tonight. And that candle is lit in honor of the memory of loved ones who are not with us. A loving mom, loving parents, grandparents, and other aunts and uncles and cousins and friends. Lovingly tonight, we remember the names of Fatima's mom, Fernanda, of Aunt Christina, of Andy and Nancy Capasso, great-grandparents Ruth and George Law, and Grandma Roni, Michael, and many other names of family members who are not with us. We also want to acknowledge everyone here tonight so that you can be with us and be able to celebrate as we go on in Andrew's life. I ask you to rise as one congregation as we all sit together. The Kaddish on page 26. Ecuadorweddingdestination may rabo. We are more the prophet of Tavi and Lake Mountain. The Hayat home of your metro, the Hayat of all Bank Israel. Father Lord, the Mankari, we do amen. The Heshme rabo, the Varach, the Alam, all the Mayamaya. Yid May the Father of peace send peace to all who mourn and comfort all the grieved among us, all of your households, and in their households, and let us all say, Amen. Please be seated. After this service is coming to a close, we have acknowledged, I think, almost everybody within the family. There is one other member of the family who is not with us tonight, and that is Frank, who is departing. We hope that he is able to return to family as quickly as possible, and we want to thank him for his service to our country. Again, I think we've thanked everybody. We thanked everybody for being here to share with this family tonight. And the best part about this celebration is telling them that it is coming to a close. And what I would like to do is I would like to do a very special blessing for Andrew. So Andrew, if you can come to in front of the podium. No, this is the back. Mom and Dad, you're going to come up here also, on either side of him. And Andrew's two sisters are also going to come up on either side. What I'm going to do, every time I do a blessing, I always take the talis and place it over the shoulders of the family. What I'm doing is I'm taking Andrew's talis. And I'm taking it and I'm placing it over everybody's shoulders. Yivarechachav denai v'yishmeracha, may the Lord bless you and keep you. Yair denai panai v'lecha v'yifonecha, yisa'a denai panai v'lecha v'yasein l'cha shalom. May you have joy and happiness, and may you have the greatest gift, the gift of shalom, you get the peace. In your home, in your hearts, and in your wonderful lives together, and let us all say, Amen. Andrew, this service has come to a close. I have been honored.
Everybody here! You think everyone here is ready for your brother? She says you guys aren't ready. Are you guys ready for our guest of honor? Make some noise! So we're gonna start a little chant, so maybe he can hear us. Not one, but we brought you two girls, Andrew. Alright, make some noise. when I say Shirley Temple, you have to meet your partner in the middle. High five, low five, booty bump, back to your side. You're good. You are good. When I say Dr. Pepper, you're gonna have to freeze. But when you freeze, you gotta do like the mannequin challenge type of thing, which we're gonna do later. So everyone, back up, back up. Coke. Ooh. You two, come here, come here. What are your names? Everyone spread it out.